हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय क्लास। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अ पोयम ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 5। द नेम ऑफ द पोयम इज़ वेयर डू ऑल द टीचर्स गो। एट फर्स्ट इट इज़ गिवन दैट एट फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट दिस पोयम, मीन्स इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द पोयम। इट इज़ गिवन दैट दिस पोयम आस्क्स अबाउट अ चाइल्ड्स लव एंड क्यूरियसिटी फॉर हिज हर टीचर। For a child, it is given in your text, you can see, for a child, a teacher is special. It is difficult for a small child to think of his or her teacher as an ordinary person. Means they don't think that their teacher are ordinary person, ordinary human beings. So let us see what the child think about his or her teacher. So the first stanza is, where do all the teachers go when it's 4 o'clock? Do they live in houses and do they wash their socks? In this stanza, the child wonders and questions where all the teachers go after the school hours are over. When the school is closed, when school hours are over, at that time, where all the teachers go? When it is 4 o'clock, at 4 o'clock, where do all the teachers go? He wants to know if, like any other ordinary being, they also live in houses and wash their socks. Means, do they also do all the routine work like other people? They are curious to know about these things. Now come to the second stanza. The second stanza is, do they wear pajamas and do they watch TV and do they pick their noses the same as you and me? In this stanza, the child wants to know if teachers also wear clothes like pajamas and they also watch TV like them. Do they also clean their noses the way other people do and they waste their time? So the child is curious to know all things related to the teacher. Now come to the next stanza. The next stanza is, do they live with other people? Have they moms and dads? And were they ever bad? Further, means here you can say, and after that, the child wonders by asking if they are also surrounded by people. Means the teachers are also surrounded by the people, or they live alone. If they also have parents and children like us to live with, or they don't have. Did they commit any mistakes or did anything wrong when they were children, or they didn't do any wrong thing in their childhood? The child is curious to know all these things related to the teacher. Now come to the next stanza. Did they ever never spell right? Did they ever make mistakes? Were they punished in the corner if they pinched the chocolate flakes? In this stanza, now the child wants to know if they also made mistakes or were ever punished for stealing chocolates like them or doing any silly or naughty things like them, and they were being punished. He want to know all these things related to the teacher. Now come to the next stanza. Did they lose their hymns books? Did they ever leave their greens? Did they scribble on the desktops? Did they wear old dirty jeans? In this stanza, the Heimdus, the meaning of Heimdus is religious books. Okay, here it is given Heimdus. The meaning of Heimdus is religious books. In this in this stanza, the child is also bothered to know if their teachers also even lost their religious books and said no to green vegetables like them. The children have the quality that they don't like to eat the green vegetables. That's why the child also think that they even said no to green vegetables. Did they also waste time by scribbling on tables? Scribbling means drawing or writing something that is not readable. Okay, scribbling on tables and wear torn and old jeans like them, or they don't did these kinds of things in their life. Now come to the next and last stanza, that is, I will follow one back home today. I will find out what they do, then I will put it in a poem that they can read to you. To overcome his curiosity to find out, to overcome his curiosity, the child decides to follow a spy. Here you can say follow his teacher on his way home after school. The child wants to follow his teacher after the school is over. Once he is clear about everything, he would also like to compose or write poem about it, about the teacher, and thinks that the teacher would read that poem to his students. And he also thinks that the poem that is written by the child would be read in the class among the students. This is the curiosity, this is the thinking of the child in this poem. Thank you. Have a nice day.